Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. So Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh God, you are my God, all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I desire. Oh God, you are my God, you're all I want, all I. Jesus, take me, mold and make me, yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh Jesus, take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you. Oh God, you are my God, you are take me, mold and make me, I yield my life to you.
Prophecy in the house tonight, as it always is, spirit of praise and thanksgiving. Father, we thank you for your high praises in our mouth. Father, we thank you for a sharp two-edged sword in our hand. Father, we thank you for the flowing of your mighty presence and power and glory from the very soul of my life, emotions of my life. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord, that you fill us now. Fill me now, oh God. Fill me now, Lord. Fill me now, oh God. Let your glory sweep over my soul. Fill me now, oh God. Let your glory overwhelm every part of my life. Oh, fill me now, oh Lord, with the great shining of your power. Divine authority, Lord. Fill us now. We yield to you now, oh God. We yield to you. Hallelujah. Woohoo! Joy unspeakable. It's full of glory. Mama, na 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 na. Thank you, Jesus. Take it up. Marabre bestiore de cadastalis.
We are the people of God, and you are our Lord. Lord, we are the people of God, and you are our Lord. are the people of God, and you are our Lord. We are the people of God, and you are our Lord. Oh, we are your people, oh God, and you are our Lord. We are your people, oh God, and you are our Lord. Oh, we are your people, oh God, and you are our Lord. Oh, we are your people, oh God, and you are our Lord.
Consuming fire, burning me.
consuming fire. Burning me. Lord, your word is like a fire. Burning me. Lord, your word is like a fire. Burning me. Oh, consuming fire. Burning me. Oh, consuming fire. Burning me. Oh, burn, burn, burn. In my soul. 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 Burn, burn, burn.
Let your glory now be revealed, O Lord, in me. Let your glory be revealed in your church, O God. Let your glory be revealed in this place, O God. Let your glory be revealed in me, O Lord. I yield myself to you, O Lord. I yield myself to you.
Come on. Come on.
Oh,
Father, we thank you that there's healing in the house right now. Hallelujah. Oh, God. Boy, you ought to let me have that keyboard. I'll start banging on that thing. Oh, Lord. Oh, God. Let your glory. Sincere with God, who can say from the heart, to say with me, your kingdom now, O God, your glory now. That's really all it takes. Now, if you're not actually drunk in the Holy Ghost after saying that, then you need to stick with it a little bit longer, because it, Father, you call the answers. It doesn't, Scripture doesn't say you call and he delays.
Amen. Thank you,
Jesus. Your kingdom now, God. Like the Hallelujah, Lord, we worship you. Oh God, we worship you. You guys got to turn this stuff down up here. These people, I'm going to have to pray that they get hearing. I mean, come on now. Oh, she baranamanas. Get busted. I mean, I don't need that. There's enough people that are deaf without making some people deaf. Jesus. Hallelujah. I feel like taking up an offering right now for a new soundboard that we can have up here and control the thing from the platform. Hallelujah. Come on, man. I want y'all guys to hook up in faith with me, because the way the sound system is, it just can't go on like this. It's ridiculous. It's just ridiculous. You know, I'm having to pray for people with ears literally that are getting damaged. And so, my good thing is Father's in the house. You know, if you came in here sick or afflicted, right now we've already been in the atmosphere to get healed already. Now, I can't, if you don't know how to plug into it, that's between you and Jesus, because I can't get involved in that. I can show you how, hallelujah. You know, I said, Lord, what do I do? He said, what do you mean? I said, Lord, what do I need to do? He said, what do you mean, what do you need to do? I've already done it. They're not going to get anything from you. They got to come to me. All you can do is advertise. People got what they want from God. They got what they're willing to have. And I pray tonight in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth that you're unwilling to have anything less than everything he's given. You know, sometimes it's like I'm having to try to create and make doctrines for people's situations. You know, it's like getting situations, it's like I say, well, you know, I can't really validate it in the scripture, but it must be that the Lord is willing to have mercy and a relationship with people who are unwilling to grow and mature and to stay babies their whole entire sojourn here in this earth. And all I can say to you is, I write unto you, you little children, because your sins are forgiven you for his name's sake. And there's not a lot of good things to say. I mean, I can't even imagine pastoring a church where I had to say to people, instead of, come on now, step into the fullness of the measure of the maturity of the ministry of Jesus, I had to say, okay, folks, just be prepared to be tossed by every wind of doctrine and the tricks of men, huh? Because you're little children, huh? And just go ahead and just be prepared to continue on in the foolishness of one saying I'm of Apollos, one saying I'm of Paul, living in your strife. And because, you know, and my goodness, just try to mitigate. God still loves you and has mercy on you. It's like the guy dislocating his jaw to put the cigar in, cussing in between. You know, it's just like, there's no way, you know. I mean, there's no way for that. But, I mean, I think there is. I think God's merciful. He's just amazingly merciful. But I'm not telling you right now, I'm not going to be the leader of the baby club. Pacifier people, you know. Hallelujah. And you know, sometimes I feel like the Lord says, why not I have to be? And I just like say, no, Papa, I'm gonna step up, Father, I'm gonna step up.
Yes.
You know, I look back in history, I was thinking today about William Booth. William Booth changed the world, him and his little wife. They changed the world. Why? Because they were radical. You know, it's like sometimes I think that if the Lord would have said, be still and whisper, everybody would fit in.
But he didn't say be still and whisper. He said, clap your hands, all you people, shout unto God with a voice of triumph.
Call to praise.
You know, I don't know how many times I've told you guys this, but I've found if I have any kind of sickness or any kind of disease coming at me or any kind of oppressive thing coming at me, I just begin to shout. I begin to holler out. I begin to holler out. I holler out until the thing is busted. No. You say, well, I don't believe God to do all that. Well, then will you show me how you do it? I'm wide open. Show me how you live free from sickness and disease and sin. I'm wide open. Show me how you hook up with the Holy Ghost and flow in the gifts of the Spirit. I'd like to learn. Meanwhile, I'm going to do what everybody in the Bible did. I'm going to cry out. I'll lift up my voice. I'm going to call. And he's going to answer. I'm going to let a sound flow. You know, the bottom line of it is the Lord never made it anything other in the New Testament. You can talk about all the still small voice you want, and he does come as a still small voice. But that's what's going on with Elijah. He doesn't have what you and I have. What God did when he gave us, what he gave to us, was a rushing mighty wind. It's a sound of rivers. It's a sound of rivers. He moves, the ground trembles and shakes. You ever been out? I've been up in the Sierras when there's been a real serious earthquake. And all the trees sound like they're singing. Everything starts shaking. And it gets loud. And of course, ground's moving around too. The limbs move, the leaves move. It's wild. In the middle of the night, 3 o'clock in the morning. Ann and I were in the Sierras and the earthquake took place. And it was a sound. It was a great sound. It didn't cause me unrest. I thought it was beautiful. That's the movings of my papa. He decided to visit the Sierras that night. Oh, yeah. Did you see what he prepared to take? Did you see the bouquet that he set for us to come to the meeting tonight? The sunset? That's his watercolor. He did that.
Yes.
He did that. Yes. He's a multitasker, getting us all encouraged and just doing it all for us. And we're just overwhelmed with his beauty. So we get to his house and we're just like, ooh, hallelujah. No, I'm going to tell you, I'm going to confess. I had some kind of virus trying to hit my body on the way to the meeting. You know how you feel, start feeling all weak, you start feeling that thing coming. It's gone now. It's gone. Why? No. Why? Why? Simply because I'm going to participate with the Holy Ghost. I don't need you to applaud. I need you to do it.
Yes.
Yeah. This isn't for information only. We're so excited for the pastor. He came sick and now he's healed. And it is just the beginning of the meeting. No. It's time that God's people. Listen. God. It's like the man of God said. It's been so many times it's been said. Fire cannot fall on an empty altar. Fire has never fallen on an empty altar. The sacrifice that's got to be there is a sacrifice of your life and my life, holy and acceptable, completely given over to the Lord. You show me a bunch of people, you gather a bunch of people who've laid down their life for the ministry, given themselves for souls, even I don't care how much fruit they've had or haven't had. You get them in one place and you're going to have a moving of God. You just get two or three people in a church meeting that have given their life completely over to God. You're going to have a move of God. Everybody else can just enjoy it. The overflow of it. You're like, wow, what's going on? I have a couple of people here fully giving themselves over to the Lord and fire's falling. And so what happens if you do that? What happens if you just totally surrender yourself over to him?
Amen.
Amen. Amen. And what do I mean by that in a very practical way? You don't let sorrow or sickness or disease or worry or concern exalt itself above his name.
Amen.
You don't let the physical body, the state of your being, the news that you received have any effect on you. You bust through it. You bust through it. Somebody said, how? You learn how to pray. I've been telling some of you about stopping the "now I lay me down to sleep" prayer for a long time. And one day you're going to get it, and you're going to come to me and you're going to say, "Pastor, I'm telling you right now, please forgive me. I thought you were just joking. I didn't understand your words. I just thought you were making something up. I didn't realize it. I never realized that that's what I was doing." There is a realm where the power of God takes hold of you, man. Amen. And doubt cannot exist there. There's a realm of glory where God takes hold of you, and no shadow of darkness can be there, no sickness nor disease, no pain. And when you find it, then when people are talking to you, I mean, I have people just because it's something I am a recipient of. And when I find the realms of faith in other people, I can text them and say, "Be healed in Jesus' name," and they're healed. Amen. And so can you, but you can't do it based on some formula or idea or philosophy because the Bible says you can do it. No. These things are reality. You can do these things that the Word of God says because you've learned a relationship with Christ Jesus where He's able to be expressed through you, revealed through you, to you. To you. To you. To you. When you have an encounter with Him, and I'm in expectation that you're going to have an encounter with Him tonight. You know, there are times where it's like, you know, I feel like there's some kind of a hindrance there for me. You know what I do? I pray in the Holy Ghost till the hindrance is gone. Come on. I just pray. I walk around and give thanks to God, pray in the Holy Ghost until there is no hindrance, until I'm overwhelmed with His glory, till I have Pentecost. I'm going to have Pentecost. I'm going to stagger around in the Mosadeta, Biki Liviarasa. I'm going to come to a place in prayer and praise and worship, even at home, where I can feel Him standing right there. Where I can feel Him breathing on the side of my face. You don't, pain doesn't have to ruin your life and run your life. All you have to do is be willing to take hold of yourself and muster all the strength that's available to you. And cry out to God, and suddenly a divine strength will all of a sudden emerge. And it shouldn't be that way, because that's almost like priming the Holy Ghost pump. But I'm just trying to just talk to you about every possible condition and situation, so that I don't care where you're at, what state you're in, if you're willing to obey God and begin to move in faith, you will find the overwhelming provision of heaven supplied to you for whatever your need is. Say this. Say, "Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit.
Let your joy come gushing through me with joy unspeakable." Hallelujah. See? It's hard to even get it out because you already start flowing in the joy. You're already overwhelmed with the joy. I'm getting drunk saying and talking about it. And it's the same way with love. And yet, if you've not been willing to hook up with the Holy Spirit, you can never know these things. They never are real to you. You're like, "Holy Spirit, come fill me with your joy." Well, you can break through that.
Where's the Holy Spirit?
You can break through that. Hey, baby. It's really going to be a big deal when you start, you know, are in situations and where your body is trying to impose things upon you that it has no right to, just from a natural perspective of the body getting old and decaying and slowing down. Somebody said old age is indicated by frayed DNA. I speak to my DNA, and I'm not having no frayed DNA. You talk about sloppy. They had a torn britches or something, man. I don't believe that anyways.
I don't either.
I don't believe that. Just from a molecular biological point of view, there's too many histones around the DNA. It's just too, the structure of it is too encapsulated. People come up with crazy ideas. That's another subject. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Praise the name of Jesus. I want you to stand there, some of you, and say, praise the name of Jesus, until you crack a smile or something. Hey, let me tell you right now, fire can't fall on an empty altar. And a living sacrifice is something that is given over to the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. 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 Yeah, that's healing water right there. That's healing water right there. Oh, God. We're so hungry and thirsty for you. Oh, God. Oh, Lord. Come and fill this place right now. And I, you know, if that would just become the part of your life, listen to me. If it would just become the part of your life, tomorrow morning, wherever you're at, whatever situation you're in the midst of crisis, in the midst of argument, in the midst of sickness, in the midst of whatever seemingly defeat might seem to come your way, you just begin to cry out, oh God, oh Lord, let your presence fill me now. No, listen to me. Let me tell you something. You don't have to pray that too long until things start moving around. Hallelujah. Yeah, that's right. Yeah, a couple of people are being more than a hearer right now. Just a couple of you are being more than a hearer right now. At some point in your life, you got to do it. You just got to do it. Oh, mama sata. Oh, mama sata. Hallelujah. You know, I had a person recently, you know, they came to the meeting and, you know, they want me to pray for them. And I started probing and finding out what was going on and discovered that they were both in adultery. They told me. And it wasn't a discernment. I said, guys, you can't be in adultery, be right with God. You're on your way to an eternity without God. You're going to wake up in hell tonight if you die. And they said, well, we came to church to worship and feel good. Well, if all we've known about worship makes the adulterer feel good, my goodness, we are mess stinking up, upside down, backwards. We're not even started. Worship that William Booth participated in, Holy Ghost conviction fell on the place. People cried out to God who hardly did anything wrong. Yes. I mean, that's the moving of God. We've accommodated a bunch of stinking nonsense, dear people. Jesus. Looky here now. Father wants to change everything about your understanding of who He is. Father, you know, Father, just think about it. Father wants us to participate with Him in the holies of holies. And have to have an encounter with God to even know what that means. Because He alone defines holy and sacred. You can look at all the various different outworkings and effects of the holies of holies in the Old Testament. Still don't know what it means. Until you stand there in that glory. Many people today in the 20th century, in the 21st century, know nothing about revival. They know nothing about the moving of God. They know nothing about the overwhelming presence of the Holy Ghost that convinces every man, that reveals to every man to where that there can be no sin left in the place, because God the Holy Spirit so makes it radically revealed, and at the same time reveals the blood of Jesus to cleanse and that grace to cause us to stand in that place holy and acceptable. Now, no, if adulterers and homosexuals and, you know, whoremongers or pornography addicts, same thing, or murderers of men and by their words and their lies and strife creators and sedition creators can actually feel good when the church is worshiping, something's wrong, because God doesn't accept that praise. In fact, Paul said, all that does is ruin the sacrifice. He says it. He says, all you've done is you've allowed that in there, and it's ruined the whole lump. The whole thing is messed up. And then he says, don't you allow it. And he goes into it radically in 1 Corinthians chapter 5, then steps it up to a whole nother level, you know, in chapter 6. And it's not the only places that he highlights these things and hearkens, you know, cries out for the people of God to hearken into the voice of the Lord. Because we compromise so much that ultimately we end up in another place. We end up in an altogether different place than where God has called us to come. When you come to Him, there's healing in the house. You know you're in the right place, because I'm in the right place. Healing's in the house. I'm in the right place because joy is in the house. I'm in the right place because praise is filling my soul. I'm in the right place because if there's any sin going on, it's going to be dealt with first by the blood of Jesus Christ. Huh? Things have gone really south in people's understanding, and it's just time for revival. It's time for the moving of God. And that great revival and that great moving of God is going to happen through God's people. He's already done His work. Amen. Praise God, there was a William Booth who had an encounter with God and was willing to be a sacrifice upon the altar so the fire could fall and he could change the impact that he had. You know, I just think about people like Keith Green. And although he was primarily a preacher by music, what made him different than everybody else? He was so radical. He was so passionate. He would have never had an impact on anybody. If he had just sing some little sweet song, he would have been status quo and just been the rest, just like the rest of the people. He was radical. He was passionate. He was filling every part of his being. And so it is with every person who's ever been used by God. They don't just have a little la 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 la, live in their sin and their sickness and their disease and their pain and their torment and their aggravation. And they move past. They get delivered from all of that. How? An encounter with God. No, nothing else can do. Listen. When the crippled man had an encounter with God, he went leaping, walking and leaping and praising God. Because he had a physical need that was met. Every time you see anybody have an encounter with God, it's a wonderful and glorious thing. And tonight, Father has purposed that you have an encounter with Him too. He's not going to force it on you. Some of you will elevate going to the bathroom above a move of God here tonight. You will. And by the time the movings of God, your bladder will demand of you to leave the room. Some of you will elevate other distractions above the move of God. You will exalt things above the move of God. And though he wants you to have an encounter with him, you can't have it. Suddenly the power of God begins to move upon your life and doubt will try to come. You've got to learn how to stand up, rise up against the thing and not allow it to work in your life. And we're here to help you tonight. God's got to have an army. He wants an army. Come on. You know, Jesus said, don't you realize I could call 12 legions of angels? That'd be 12 times 6,000 approximately. And one angel can basically destroy 100,000 men. So that's, do the math. There's nobody left on the earth. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
But he can accomplish more by himself than calling. That's just because he didn't want to really, you know, dirty his hands, so to speak. He wasn't going to throw it on. He's just going to let them do it. Because by himself, he could do far more than all the angels of heaven combined. Because he created them, gave them all the power and strength in which they move in, and all the authority in which they function in. How mighty is your God? Well, then all you got to do is touch him to have whatever you need. All you got to understand is it's not begging God and trying to figure out, you know, whatever the stronghold is and what this is and what that is and the root of whatever. That's nonsense. That's another way. It's another direction. You just got to lay hold on him. You got to move in faith and you got to lay hold on him. You got to be willing to be like blind Bartimaeus and begin to cry out to God until he turns to you and says, come here. Bring him here. Bring him here. Hallelujah. 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 Somebody asked me, they said, well, why do you shout? Because he put a shout on the inside of me. Yeah, you get people worshiping God and shouting and praising him, and then it sounds like rivers. And that's what he was talking about. Hallelujah. Ooh. I mean, think about the sound of one person's voice. Is it too loud, baby? Okay, just checking because you moved. Making room for Anna to lay out? Okay. Just want to make sure. People's ears are getting ruined around here. I don't have control over the thing. I could have a meter monitor just say, show me the threshold of where it would hurt people's ears, and I would never allow it to go beyond that threshold. I'm concerned about that. You know, I had to pray for Elizabeth the other night because one of her ears are just basically, it's like a broken speaker at a certain level. And it's just nonsense. I'm not going to allow it anymore. It's just wrong. It's wrong. And then, you know, so, yeah, I just take control of it. If it's wrong, I stop it. You know what I'm saying? In my life and things around me, that's what you need to do. If it's wrong, if it's not of God, if it doesn't look like God, if it doesn't look like the moving of God, the flowing of the Holy Ghost, you need to stop it. So we're not having that. Hallelujah. And, you know, the reality of it is the power that is first submitting yourself to God. Do you know how to yield to him right now? Do you know how to yield to him right now? Can you in reality, in spirit and truth say, Lord, I yield myself to you right now. And oh, how wonderful and oh, how glorious. And oh, how majestic is your name, oh God. In all the earth. And then he begins to sing little songs like, we'll give the glory to Jesus and tell of his love. And tell of his love. I will give the glory to Jesus and tell of his wonderful love. We will give all honor to Jesus and tell of his love and tell of, I will give all honor to Jesus and tell of his wonderful love. Jesus. Holy Spirit, move in this place tonight so that there can be nothing except for truth. That falsehood could not exist among us, O God, and lies and deception could not. Let the floodlight of heaven shine, O God. Let each person recognize the authority and the power that you've given to us to be able to deal with everything that would try to stop us. Can you just begin to think with me for a little bit about all the things that tried to stop Jesus? The religion tried to stop him. The opinions of men tried to stop him. The powers of darkness tried to stop him. The assaults of the weather at times tried to stop him. He was tested in every way like we are, and he stayed flowing in the Holy Ghost. He never lost the realms of always seeing the Father, being captivated by joy. I mean, I know how happy he was because I've tasted of the realm. I know he had no sorrow because he's the one who personified the redeemed of the Lord. And the redeemed of the Lord came with singing unto Zion. And everlasting joy was upon them. Look, the enemy will try of your soul, circumstances around you, will try to impose things upon you. And you just got to be willing to rise up and get your mouth involved, engaged. Let me show you. On the day of Pentecost, it was an angel speaking in tongues while they all sit there. On the day of Pentecost, Father gave every person a voice and a tongue. Yeah. And all Jerusalem was filled with the sound of it. All Jerusalem was filled with the sound of it. I believe that there is a place of praise and worship that we could enter into that would be so superior to the natural, that would be so heavenly, so glorious, that it would literally begin to be heard all over the county. No microphones, no speakers, no amplifiers. But a sound of heaven coming forth through the redeemed, which is far greater than the shout of angels, singing, peace on earth, goodwill towards men. For unto you is born Christ the Savior in the city of David in Bethlehem. Something far greater. There's something far greater. I'm laying hold of, pressing in, making a demand of myself to have what God commanded. And when I recognize how powerful he is and how mighty he is and how that everything that he's established and said in his word is forever established and there's nothing, no power that can prevent it, then I realize, wait a minute, it's just about me. It's about what I'm willing to do. It's about how I am willing to respond. It's about how serious I'm willing to get. Yes, sir. Blind Bartimaeus got serious with God. The Syrophoenician woman got serious with God. The woman with the issue of blood got serious with God. The four who had a friend who was paralyzed, got serious with God. They weren't going to let anything stop them. Oh, my. You know, when you think about all of these different things, and everyone has a story to tell, everyone has an impact of radicalness to us, where you're willing to come, where you come to church and you're going to tear the roof down. You're going to tear the roof off to have the move of God. Because the power of the Lord was present to heal, but nobody was getting healed till somebody came and got radical and tore the roof off the place. There was many blind men sitting on the wayside, many, but only one began to cry out, oh God, Jesus.
Jesus, thou Son of David.
That's what I do. That's what I do. I learned it from the Holy Ghost, but I had a witness in blind Bartimaeus. I learned it from the Holy Ghost, but I had a witness in the Syrophoenician woman. I learned it from the Holy Ghost, but I watched it work around the walls of Jericho. I learned it from the Holy Ghost, but I saw its impact when Paul and Silas were chained to a wall in prison at night. They didn't need a CD and a fragrance candle. They had a flow of the Spirit of the living God, which once again, people, let's just stop. The Lord didn't make it like a gentle stream. He didn't say, out of your innermost being shall settle in a pond of the Spirit of the Lord. Deep, still waters. He didn't say that at all. He described it like a stream that flows down a steep mountain place. Steep mountainside, a waterfall. I'm participating with the waterfall. And tonight, in the name of Jesus, you're not going to be a pond anymore. The Lord said, speak. He didn't say, think. He said, speak. He didn't say, think. He said, shout. He didn't say, whisper. I've watched over and over again the effect of the power of God and the anointing of God upon men. I watched what happened when Elijah was touched by the presence of the Lord. Scripture says, and the hand of the Lord came upon Elijah. My goodness, look what happened when the hand of the Lord came on him. Ahab had the fastest horses in the land. He was the king. That's what pulled his chariot. Hand of the Lord comes upon Elijah, and he runs more than 6 miles, probably a little closer to 9 miles, and beats the horses there. Outruns the horses for 9 miles. And the king is driving him. He's driving his horses. Because the sound of an abundance of rain was about to come, was coming. Hallelujah. And he's just going to be stuck in the floods. Torrential rains like that. What was about to be unleashed would cause flash flooding. He'd have been stuck. All the wadis that had been dry, that turns into just... After 3 years of drought? Wow. Look what happens when the hand of the Lord comes on. You're not just sitting here meditating, cogitating. Hand of the Lord comes upon you, produces some run. No. The Spirit of the Lord came upon David. Look what happened. He began to wildly dance. I mean, I know that people have danced just out of... Look, I know that you've danced just out of a willingness to participate. But what happens is the Lord will take that into a place where it's God the Holy Ghost. And you won't get out of breath even if you're completely out of shape. Somebody said, oh, don't expect the 80-year-old guys to dance. They'll have a heart attack in the meeting. No, the Spirit of the Lord comes upon them, man. It's superior to the natural. The old man can dance and not have a heart attack and not get out of breath. No, there's something superior to the natural. We try to lock God within the framework of our natural. And there's no question about it. There is the volition of our will when everything is against us and we don't feel any inspiration and we don't feel any motivation, but yet we rise up by the authority of the Word of God and we recognize that God is who He said He is and that He's going to do what He said He'd do. And we begin to call out. We begin to call out. We begin to call out. We say, oh God, do your work now. Do it in me, Lord. Let your glory arise. We do it. if you do that in the natural, you know what's going to happen? You're going to give yourself a headache. Your throat will get sore. So you've got to learn how to go superior to the natural, where you don't get a headache, your throat doesn't get sore, you don't get out of breath, your heart doesn't collapse on you, your body doesn't grow tired. Aren't you hungry for these things? Because they're for you. They're yours. You say, and then what happens? Oh, God, do that to me. Well, he says, he's like, I've already given you everything. I've been giving you more. You have to start doing it. You have to stop willing to just accommodate everything that is coming at you when you know good and well it is absolutely anti-Christ, anti-God, anti-word, that if your life was actually a testimony of what God has done for man, it would be something contrary to the word, and you don't want that. You hear me? If your life was a testimony of what God has done through redemption at the cross and the resurrection and the ascension, the outpouring of the Holy Ghost, then it would be contrary to the word of God. It would be a false witness. And I said, I'm going to have what Father said. He's God. 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 And reality of it is, understand this, great faith does not take no for an answer. Jesus said to the Syrophoenician woman, no. Over and over again, he ignored him. That's a no, a no, a no. Ignoring somebody is a big no. She's crying after us. She won't shut up. The disciples are saying, picking up rocks, and gonna, you know. That's my amplified version. Get out of here. Trying to shut her down, telling her to be quiet. Get out of here, woman, you Phoenician, you Jezebel tribe. I said, no. She wouldn't take no for an answer. She was so set that Jesus altered the covenant for her sake. You reckon he'd do it for you? I tell you right now, he doesn't have to alter the covenant for you to get healed. He doesn't have to alter the covenant for you to get filled. I mean, we love talking about what God did in history and what God's going to do in the future. We're so certain of it. But how about right now? How about right now? How about what God's going to do right now? Father wants you to move in the expectation of the scripture where if you have no food, you can speak to the oil and you can speak to the flour and it won't diminish. Yeah. Where you can take the few loaves and fishes and you can speak to them and pray over them and they multiply and feed everybody. Oh. You got to participate with the word of the Lord right here when it's just about real little easy things, like whether or not you're going to shout or not, like whether or not you're going to feel good or not, like whether or not you're going to be healthy or not, whether or not some little virus called a flu is going to take hold of you. You don't have enough spirit of God to run it off. That's pathetic. Now, I'm talking to me. I'm just saying, you know how I'm talking to myself. That's pathetic, Spitzberg, and get with the program. And I learned how to do it. I was taught by the Holy Ghost. I saw in the spirit Jacob laying a dying, and he got up and he leaned upon his staff and he worshiped. And I realized, my goodness, he lived many years after that. So I got up and started shouting myself. I got up and started worshiping myself. I got up till the flow came out. How the glory filled my soul. Somebody said, you don't have to shout to pray. That's true, you don't. But you got to shout to get a breakthrough. You got to shout to get the flow. You got to shout to break doubt. You got to shout to see the walls come down. You got to begin to shout and worship God to see the chains broken off. I mean, come on. When the Spirit of the Lord comes upon you, you take the gates of the city and walk away. That's some serious energy. That's a surge. That is a Holy Ghost surge. Ah! in the flow. So if somebody, I'm out in the middle of the golf course or in the grocery store and somebody wants to get healed, on, I start screaming and hollering. I said, go in Jesus' name. Jesus' name, you foul spirit of hell, go. I'm living in the anointing. But if something starts trying to impose itself upon me, it's time to go to war. Huh? It's time to go to war. We don't live in war, praise God. I mean, yeah, we, you know, Satan's always fighting, but my goodness gracious, it's just like one little finger. You stand up here. Hallelujah. You submit yourself to God, resist the devil, and he flees in terror. He flees. Hallelujah. You wake up in the morning and the devil goes, oh no, she's awake. Oh no, she's up. It was bad enough when she was dreaming and wake up every once in a while and say, Jesus. Now she's up and fully engaged. Now he's up and he's talking to the Father. We're done for. I've tried every trick I got on him, says the devil, and nothing works. I've laid everything I can do and lay on him, and he's still praising you. He's still praising Jesus. He's still praising God. What are we going to do? I want every devil in hell to have a, be in a quandary over you. You know what would be the worst thing to ever have happened to you? What happened to the sons of Sceva? They were the priest's sons. I mean, my goodness, they were the Levitical priesthood. Kohathites. And they said, we adjure you by the name of Jesus whom Paul preaches. You can't have a secondhand Jesus. You can't have a second. We adjure you by the name of Jesus who Pastor Mark preaches. You can't have no secondhand Jesus. You can't have no secondhand vicarious relationship now. You got to have your own personal one. And the devil that was in that man became outraged. And the voice of the devil through that man's mouth said, Jesus, we know, Paul, we know, but you have no authority. And the man, because of this super, the strength, the power, I don't like to use supernatural for the devil. I want to use undernatural, something inferior to the natural, but it's, you know what I'm saying? I'm giving no credit. Hallelujah. A 3-year-old baby touched by the power of God can stop all hell. I said a 3-year-old baby touched with the power of God can stop all hell. So you certainly wouldn't want to give vest too much power into something like that. That a 3-year-old baby could stop the whole armies of hell? Give me a break. See, Jesus is here right now. The power of God is here right now. He is. He's touching you. I'm going to keep working with you till I pry whatever's got a hold of you off of you. Then you begin to enjoy the glory of God. You know, if you hold on to something, you're trying to fix it, you're trying to work it out, all you're going to do is go into a deeper dimension of doubt and give more place to the devil. Because there's nothing of the arm of flesh that could do anything. There, look, we got to have a miracle. Without a miracle, there is no encounter. Without a miracle, there is no touch. Without a miracle, there's no divine ability. We're just stuck. The beauty of the thing is that God's ready to work a miracle for you continually. Amen. Every day, on ongoing basis. Amen. The strength and power to that man by the demon spirit that was in him
jumped on the seven sons of Sceva and just beat them to death. They beat them to a pulp, tore their clothes off. I mean, when they came to, they were laying there naked and all beat up. Because they tried to have a secondhand Jesus. His name is only powerful upon the lips of his sons and daughters. Yes. But oh, is this his name? The Lord said, concerning this encounter that we would have with them. And you know, when the disciples received all power and authority over all sicknesses and diseases, it was because they were standing there having an encounter with God manifested in flesh. And when he tells you and I that these signs, these miracles will follow them that believe in my name, they'll cast out devils, he's talking about the result of you and I having an encounter with him. And then he's talking about you and I then being resourced by him to be in him to execute the Father's will on the earth. And sometimes that is a battle. I go to war. I learned a long time ago that some of the thoughts that I hear come to me that I know aren't my thoughts. It is the thing that Satan is pouring out and spewing out across the earth, across the land, sometimes across God's people, sometimes across the world. And what do? Do I sit there and entertain the thought and go, wow, I can't believe I'm having this bad thought. I must not be saved. Oh, I can't believe I'm having this thought. My goodness, what's wrong with me? Oh, God, forgive me. Oh, God, help me. I got a little bit more identity in God than that. I start interceding. I realize I'm on a need-to-know basis. God allows me to hear what's going on in the realms of the Spirit. Huh? Sometimes I hear people say, I hear the voice in the mind of the devil. Oh, just sleep in today. It's sunny. Just sleep in. Go outside and enjoy God's creation today. Foul spirit of hell suggesting lying words to the masses, and they have no defense against it. So I am the strong man. And you're supposed to be the strong men and women. They go, you foul spirit of hell. I cancel every one of your suggestions. I cancel every one of your lies. In the name of Jesus Christ, I bring down this spirit and this thought and this imagination now. In Jesus' name. In the name of the living God. Now, that's the effect of prayer. We want to have these little lay me down and sleep prayers. Oh God, me, mine. Huh? You know, only time you talk to God when you got some bad news. God, I'm broke. God, I'm sick. God, I'm in need. God, where are you? God, why? I'm broke down. God, why did it happen? God, get me this. God, get me that. God, I want more. God, I need more. God, why are you so delaying with the answer? Why are you on a delay schedule with the answer? No, that's not the way you walk with God. Walk with God, praising him and exalting him and extolling him for who he is. That's faith. You begin to say, Father, you're the Most High, you're the Almighty, you higher than the highest. Hallelujah. You're El Shaddai, you're sovereign. You speak and everything happens. You decree it and it surely comes to pass. You speak a thing and it's forever established, forever settled. You're the Alpha, you're the Omega, you're the beginning, you're the end. Christ Jesus, you've been exalted above all principality and power and might. You have the absolute authority and dominion. God, you reign in the kingdom of man, and you reign over me. And your word, oh God, that you have spoken is executed in my life because I agree with you, Father. I will not have it any other way. I won't have it any other way. I won't have it any other way. Hallelujah. Job was so certain about his righteousness, he was so far removed from condemnation, he brought the problem on God. That's some serious confidence in who you are in God. Think about it. No wonder God called him perfect and upright and his champion. God's got a better champion than Job now. Will you be a Noah in your generation? Will you be a Daniel in your generation? Will you be a Samuel in your generation? Will you be a Job in your generation? I mean, the Lord highlighted, I believe it was to Ezekiel. It was. He highlighted Noah, Daniel, and Job. And that's another Daniel than the book of Daniel. This is a Daniel that lived sometime between Noah and Job. Because the Daniel that we know about was alive when Ezekiel was alive. They were contemporaries. Just a man we don't know much about. Actually, his name is pronounced different if you look at it in the Hebrew language. Just the Lord, we just don't know much about him. But these men, they stood in God in their generation and they changed everything. Their impact, look at the impact. You don't understand the impact of Daniel, but you can understand the impact of Noah and Job. Is there going to be in this place, think about it tonight, is there going to be in this place, are we willing, come on Joshua, are we willing just to be broken before God, to be upon the altar of sacrifice as a holy and acceptable offering, to where that we can have the same kind of impact and even greater right now, that somewhere in the books is going to be written that your name was there because you lived? That God would do special, ordinary, unique things, alter the covenant, change the plan just for you. Because you wouldn't take no for an answer like a Syrophoenician woman. Take no for an answer. Take no for an answer and you know how to fall down and worship just as soon as he pays any attention to you. You listen to me, people. I'm going to tell you right now, you can get into a relationship with the Holy Ghost where the sound of the tongues and the language and the prayer coming out of your voice is a witness to you of how deep you're allowing the Holy Spirit to be expressed through your life, how much you're holding on yourself versus how much you're surrendering to Him. Listen, there are so many evidences and indicators in our lives of where we're at with God. And if we'll just stop and we'll get a hold of ourselves and listen to the prayer that's coming out of our mouth, whether it's or the utterance of prayer that we can understand out of the English language, suddenly we'll recognize, wait a minute, whether we're deep with Him, where we're going with Him, where we're yielded to Him, whether we're submitted to Him, where He can just, the floodgates of our life are open to Him and He has no resistance whatsoever, or whether or not we are compromised by other things, usually selfish interest. And then what do you do when you find yourself and it's just like, you know, it's weak, it's shallow, there's no power to it, there's no strength to it, there's no inspiration to it, there's no unction to it, there's no light to it. You begin to cry out to God. You begin to talk to Him in a radical, intense way, because it's a matter of life and death. It's so important to you. It's about your personal relationship. It's about your walk. It's about your strength. It's about your power to overcome. It's about your ability to stand in this place that God has assigned us to go before Him and be a witness to a world around us in Him. Amen. And it doesn't take long to grow and mature and develop in this. It doesn't take long. It doesn't take long. And then we can give the glory to Jesus and tell of His love, and tell of His love. Now I'll give the glory to Jesus and tell of His wonderful love. There is a river right now that flows from the throne of God established in your heart, in your life. Understand how to move with the Spirit of the Lord. Understand that moving with the Spirit of the Lord many times demands that you stand up against the other influences and do not yield your members to them. don't agree with. Don't let the voice of it come out of your mouth. Suddenly you say, oh, let not the inhabitants of the Lord say, I'm sick. Jesus. Jesus. I would have you to sit down, but most of you flow better than the Holy Ghost when you're standing up. Jesus. 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 Yeah. You know, the Lord is just so blessed. He's so blessed. And he's so honored that we're here in this house seeking him. He's so blessed. He's so honored that we're not willing to just be religious about the night, that we're willing to press it. And some people think, well, when the enemy's in retreat, then you can relax. You know, he's in retreat. No. If you have that kind of strategy from a military point of view, you've lost your opportunity. When the enemy's in retreat, you press it. You press it hard. You press it harder than when you were just face to face and it looked like you were being overcome. You're pressing it hard when you're being overcome. Huh? When it looks like, uh-oh, the troops are, they're breaking ranks. Uh-oh, it looks like this thing is on me. Uh-oh, it looks like devastation and disaster has taken me. Uh-oh, it looks like bad news to the good news. Uh-oh, it looks like an evil report instead of a good report. Uh-oh, it looks like God's not in the midst of this and in the midst of my life. And we have all kinds of doctrines that would give excuse for that. So the devil has all kinds of wiggle room to impose things on us. But if we stand, having done all stand, we go after the thing and we lay hold on the realms. And understand, dear people, it's always got to be about experience of manifest presence of the Lord. You can be seated. It's all about experience in his presence. Lift your hands towards heaven. Now, if you're not experiencing his presence, put one hand down. I would have never put one hand down. Not ever. Not ever. Not ever. Not ever. Because I will not ever be defeated. I will never be defeated. Why? Because Christ Jesus has given to me his victory. His overcoming power. God has assigned it. I'll say it so. When everything around me says it's not. If you could put down, I should have said, if you don't feel the manifest presence of the Lord, instead of put down one of your hands, cry out all the more. If you're not feeling the presence of the Lord, you should be crying out louder than anybody in the house. And really, out of reality of it is, most of the time you won't, because the same thing that has shut your mouth is the same thing that is preventing you from experiencing the presence of the Lord. I want you to hear me. I want you to hear me. I want you to listen to me. It might look messy to start with, but it's going to be glorious to end with. Woo-hoo! Oh, God, your glory, your fire, your presence, your overwhelming, miraculous power of grace and of faith in Avalon. Hallelujah. Oh,
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Somebody said, oh, they're always hollering over there. They just hollering, my goodness gracious. They just hollering, making a mess of the whole thing. No. We're unwilling to sit to be a part of the status quo that has been nothing less than a representation of what man can do. Hello. God said that His kingdom is not in talk, but in power. Somebody said, well, I don't believe all that hollering and everything's about power and demonstration of the Holy Ghost. Well, it may not be, but it's going to break the stronghold and the wall of interference that has kept us from the flow that is obviously very absent in the majority of the church, if not all the church in the Western world. And to allow it, to accommodate it, to settle for anything less than a glorious church that's filled with all the fullness of God is pathetic. It's certainly not valiant. Certainly not honorable. It certainly has no indication of someone being a champion for God. Watch out. Don't make sure you don't allow yourself to become a champion for this thing, that thing, and the other thing. Meanwhile, God just got to just, you know, get whatever's left over. And the tables are turned. And you telling him he can have the crumbs that fall from the children's table. Uh-oh, we better watch out, eh? Because Satan is a mocker of God and a mocker of God's saints. And he wants to turn this thing around and make it look like a shame. And make it look so ridiculous. And make it look so powerless. And make it look so human. So pathetic. But would there be in this place tonight, besides me? A Noah, a Daniel, a Job. And the Lord says it in the context of preventing the calamity that is certain to come because of men's sin and iniquity and ungodliness and unwillingness to walk with Him and know Him. There was a person like Noah that could make an intercession that could turn the tide back. A person like Daniel, who walked in some kind of extraordinary wisdom. That in the midst of all the iniquity, yet he could grab a hold of the glory and the power of God and bring the preservation of relationship between God and man and see it witnessed and established even as Job did. I have a righteous man in the earth. Papa's amazing. You need to think about it. Most of us would be ashamed to have only one person in our church. The Father walks in such humility and brokenness, He was proud of having one member. I got Job. If you were standing in an audience of a bunch of people, they're just standing around talking, one says, I got 5,000 members, I got another says, I got 10,000, one says, I got 30,000, one says, I got 500,000, like in Nigeria and some other place. And the other guy says, 1,000, how many do you have? I have one. And you don't, but you say it confidently and boldly, hey, I got one. I got one. And He is mighty. He is righteous and upright in all of His ways.
Hallelujah.
The Lord didn't need many.
No.
120 is all that would come. So 120 would do. It's not a magic number. He could have got it done with three. Just so happened to be 120 showed up. 120 smart people. Out of the thousands, tens of thousands, hundreds of thousands, it was touched by His glory that had an encounter with Him. How many just on the one single day, on just one single day? It was a three-day revival, but how many on just the one single day that ate of the loaves and the fishes when there was 5,000 men, not counting men and women? There was easily 50,000 people there, and it's probably more realistic to say 30,000. It's got 120. That's just one day out of 3 years of days. 365 times three. Over more than 1,000 days like this. People being touched by the power and the glory of God and seeing the manifest presence of the Lord. Father's calling us into a realm, dear people, that I know that He wants us to grab it and lay hold on it and be intense about it. I believe that Peter, James, and John was allowed to go to the Mount of Transfiguration because they were intense about Jesus. They were intense about following Him around. When everybody else was basically sleeping, they were up saying, what are you doing now? Now what are we going to do? Now what's happening? Can I get you something? They would have been sticking to Him like Elisha stuck to Elijah. I promise you, it wasn't just a random event, I'll take Peter, James, and John. No, there was a passion, a determination. I can imagine Peter sleeping with one hand on Jesus at night. John's got his foot, hand on his foot. And James got his hand on John. If anybody moves, they're all moving. Their faces lit up with the glory of God because they encountered that place in God where those kinds of divine expressions happen. When God steps in to the midst of our lives, it's a shout and a sound of great thunder and blastings, and the sounding of like as a trumpet that grows louder and louder and louder until the people who are in the natural realm are putting their hands over their ears because it's about to explode. They feel like they're about to die, but the people who are captivated with love with Him are now just being transfigured and raptured, caught away with the sound of His voice. That's never going to happen until you and I get radical about having what they had, about what the Scripture describes, or making God the God He is. We want to make God something different than He describes Himself to be. One time the Lord said to me, ask the people what I need to do so they would like me more. Where do I need to change so that I would be more acceptable to them? Well, Lord, I would like you a lot better if we didn't have to be happy all the time. I can't imagine anybody saying that, but who knows? People act like that. God wrote the things He wrote to you that your joy may be full, and quit acting like you some kind of an exception. Because that's nothing but doubt and unbelief. It's about time you get fighting mad and start punching something. Not a person. And not yourself. The adversary. Yeah. Not with the arm of flesh, but with the strength of the Lord made available to you by the Spirit of the Lord. Amen. Weapons of our warfare, they're not carnal. Yes. They're not carnal, people. They're mighty. They're God. It's God power. It's God power. Your needs tonight. The amount of anointing that we need to meet your needs tonight is a small scale. It's a small scale. Truly, truly is. You don't need a cannon, a tank, to go deer hunting. And if you do, there would be nothing left of the deer that you're shot. You just need a rifle. Huh? Amen. So it takes a little bit of anointing to get your provision. Just a little bit of anointing to get your provision. Look at all the people in the Old Testament that stand as a witness to us of what little bit of anointing that they had and what little bit of an encounter that they had and all the provision that it resulted in and all the glory and all the blessings that it resulted in. And now, Father, having raised up Christ Jesus far above all principalities, powers, and might, and exalted Him above every name that is in name, giving Him a name that is above every name, is now seated in this realm of divine power and grace to pour out upon us the Holy Ghost so that we may walk in His power, in His authority, I mean, the last thing that you and I should have is a need. Amen. Tonight, Father wants to work a miracle for you.
Yes.
Father wants to work a miracle of physical healing for your body. Wants to make work a miracle of mental health for your body. Wants to work a miracle of marital status for your life. Oh, they say, oh, that's just common. Oh, if it's common and natural, you're going to get the wrong one. You want the miracle one.
Amen.
You want the one that God ordained, huh? Though you women, you want the man that found favor with the Lord. Hallelujah. Woo, I'm breathing on you the faith of God right now. Hallelujah. That the one who found favor with the Lord will also find you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And you'll get on with the blessings that God placed in our lives in that realm.
Amen.
And it is good. Praise God. Yeah. Everybody knows it's good. Say thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Amen.
Amen.
I love all my children. We didn't want to see them go, but now we're kind of like, wow, this is really cool. Just me and Ann, you know. Wow. This is amazing. Wow, Father, you did it so perfect.
Yes.
Everything you did is so perfect. The way you made the sun to shine is perfect. The way you painted the clouds for me. Might not have been for you, but it was definitely for me. It's not for you unless you believe it's for you.
That's right.
You can exclude yourself. It was for me. I'm not a super. He painted those clouds for me. He said, look at this. I want to show you this. Look at what I'm going to do today. God's watercolor. I was just like, oh, look at this. Oh, you're amazing. Somebody said, oh, I'm thinking it'd be a physical explanation based on physics. I don't know what they're talking about. It doesn't work that way. Oh, I can prove it. You can't prove nothing. The day you can do it and make it happen is the day you can prove it. Till then, Papa's doing it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Exceedingly, Papa's doing it. He makes the sun to rise in the morning. It doesn't just happen because of some idea about the way the solar system works. Nonsense. Nonsense. He says, come up. He says, come shine for Mark today. Every day is beautiful, isn't it, baby? Whether it's raining or a storm. Huh? Every day is a perfect day because it's the one that he made. And it's a gift to you and me.
Amen.
And if we're not willing just to open up our eyes and see on a basic level relationship with him, how are we going to move in to that which is superior to the natural? We're allowing all the evil things that Satan is doing to catch our attention when there's far more with him than are with them.
Amen.
Adam and Eve had millions of trees and millions of beautiful things to enjoy, and they became fixated on the one wrong thing. Showing every human being their place of downfall. I refuse to look at the bad. There's too much good to behold. I refuse to talk about some little negative situation when there's all these wonderful things that God is doing. Come on, people. It's called thanksgiving. It's called praise. God wants to break it down for you. He wants you to get out of whatever prison you've been living in. Start enjoying what he's freely given.
Amen.
God spared not his own son, but offered him up for the sins of us all. How shall he not also by him freely give us all things? I said all things.
All things.
So what do you want? So what would you like? What are you missing in the all things here tonight? I'm like looking, oh God, I want to move into greater faith. Father, I want to move in that greater dimension of awareness with you and participating with you, Lord, that I raise every person that's dead from the dead. Did I encounter? I want to go downtown and I want to speak. I want to open up every one of those places where the people are laying in the morgue, those morgue drawers. And say, get up, get up, get up, get up. Walk out of there with a whole army of people needing to get dressed. For me, it's fine for them to be naked. I mean, my goodness, it's an anointing. You're not lusting after anything. Besides that, how can you get lust, be in lust over there anyways? Let them be naked. You just be that much more of a show. Are you listening to me? Come on now. Come on. You live in the anointing, and none of those things work on you. None of the lust of the flesh works on you. Don't work on you. Can't work on you. You feel the moving of anything that is demonic, and you don't want it. No matter what pleasure center it would try to activate, because it's not a pleasure center at all. It's a destructive center. And it's not in us, but it can touch us. But if we don't allow it, it has no place. We don't allow it because we're over here in this realm, and we're in this realm so desperate, so intense about pressing this. I'm going to go preach tomorrow. I don't know what you're going to do. You can go earn your money. I can tell you right now, you'll never get ahead. I'll never get ahead. I'm going to go lift up Jesus. You might get all involved in the stress if you want to, not me. I'm going to enjoy it. I'm going to enjoy myself. Hallelujah. I'm going to sing praises to the Lord. I'm going to cry out to God and say, oh, God, use me more. A sacrifice means I'm completely given over to Him. I've been turned into smoke. Hey, if you don't light that sacrifice on fire quick, it starts, stinking bad. Thing better be burning. This smells like barbecue. Are you with me?
Yeah.
It smells like barbecue over here. Boy, that's delicious. That smells delicious. Better get some fire on that altar quick, otherwise it's going to be foul, bloated, foul, smelling, run you out of the house. Run you out of the place. I'm going to be a sacrifice that's burning, turned into smoke. Somebody said, what does that look like in a practical way? I'm going to live fully for Jesus. I've got an assignment to represent heaven to humanity.
Yes, sir.
I can't represent heaven between coughs. and by the way, Jesus is the healer. Are you listening to me? I'd choke that thing down, man. You know what? Come on, are you listening to me? Come on, people. Come on, people. Let's we've got to be more vested in this. We have to take more personal responsibility for how we represent Him. And when we do, I promise you, I tell you, the doubt and the unbelief that held you in the sickness, held you in the disease, held you in the torment, held you in a place where you've not been able to enjoy all the wonderful things that belong to a greater manifestation of His presence. Does everybody realize that everybody at least gets some token of His presence? And if you're not feeling His presence, you're dead, and somebody turns you into a zombie, and I don't know how you got here. You with me? Everybody, He sends His rain upon the just and the unjust. He makes His sun to shine upon the wicked and the righteous. Hello. Quit giving yourself such a hard way to go. Wake up and smell the roses. Behold the goodness of God. Go stargazing and I go, oh God, You're so good. Oh, look at You. God, look what all You did. Then I think about what all He's done in me. Everything has to be in right, in this right and proper order. Everything has to be put in place. If it's not in every place, it's not going to be in any place. You've got to learn how to receive this abundance of life. It's an extraordinary life. And if you don't recognize that the thief has come to steal the extraordinary life from you, there's no way. Get yourself a Holy Ghost surveillance system. Hello. Cameras, monitors, direct lines to the National Guard and the Marines. If anybody, get yourself 10 locks on your door. Don't get yourself one of those wood doors. Get yourself one of those, steel doors. It's like, 6 inches thick. You can't blow it up. You got to get nitro to blow it up. In the realms of the Spirit. even more interested in their own natural security than in their spiritual security. They're more aware of the natural thief and afraid and do everything that they need to do to set in order protections against the natural thief than against the spiritual thief. Wake up. Your problem's not God's fault. And any problem you have, and any disease that you have, and any issues that you have, any affliction you have, any torment you have, God is your Savior, and He's dedicated to seeing you totally set free. And if you've been baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire, the responsible, you're responsible to get it done between you and Him, your personal relationship. Not have a secondhand Jesus. In the name of Jesus, whom Pastor Mark believes in, I command this evil thing to leave me alone. I'm going to go away. It's going to get worse. I know I kept you like to 12 o'clock on Wednesday night. I'm planning on letting you go early tonight so that you can get rest. Rest is good. Rest is important. You can step into a supernatural realm where you don't need much of it, but until you can step into a supernatural realm where you're smiling and praising God, you don't have any possibility of having a supernatural realm where you don't need rest. Do you hear me? Listen, come on, you got to have one to have the other. You got to enjoy the first part to have enjoy the second part.
Amen.
If you can't see what He's done for you, if you're not all happy about the fact that your name's written in the Lamb's Book of Life, that should be enough to cause you to dance all day long. My name is written in the Lamb's Book of Life. I'm on my way to heaven. God is my friend. He's my friend. Yeah. I'm His son, His daughter.
Amen.
I've been washed in the blood.
Amen.
I'm kept by the power of God. He who began a good work in me is going to complete. I mean, I got all these promises of God, of security. Now unto Him who is able to keep you from falling and present you faultless. Who can lay any charge to God's elect? It's God who's justified. It's God who's made righteous. That's pretty radical. I'm God's elect. Nobody can lay any charge to me. You do, and I feel sorry for you. Because Father's jealous over His friends and His family. He's jealous. Jealous over us with a holy jealousy. And that word jealousy is also translated zeal. And it's a display of radical emotion. The zeal of the Lord consumed Jesus. Look at that. He makes a whip and drives everybody out. Ah! I promise you, He was using it. He wasn't just threatening. My dad's house. And I'm not going to stand here and allow the status quo to exist that would hold back the manifestation of His power and of His glory. And that same zeal that is in Him is in me, and it's supposed to be in you. It's supposed to be in every one of us. And I'm telling you tonight, in the name of Jesus, you're going to have the miracle encounter. You know, when you think about it, his eyes go to and fro. And He's looking for a special kind of people.
I'm here!
That's right. He's not just looking for anyone. He's looking for a special kind of people. He squints. He's looking for a special... His eyelids try. He's looking for people who are hungry for the kingdom of God to be manifested through their life. They're hungry for heaven. They're hungry for the authority of heaven. The glory of heaven, relationship with a Father, a walk with God, something that belongs to a love that we know little about unless we allow the Holy Spirit to teach us, because it's a love that's on the basis of purity and truth and sincerity and transparency and humility and brokenness and meekness and childlikeness that doesn't fade away or change, that's real day in, day out, minute in, minute out. And all we have to do is begin to allow God to work this glorious miracle in our lives. It is a miracle of a continual ongoing wellspring. But if you don't believe you have a wellspring, guess what? You don't have one. Because until you agree with God and who He is and what He can do, you can't have the miracle. Until the blind man believes Jesus can open up his eyes, he's going to remain blind.
Yes.
It's just the way it is. Without faith, it's impossible to please God, because everything that God is going to do in our lives is going to be our willing cooperation with Him, to believe Him, to agree with Him. It's the fundamental basis of what faith means, to agree with Him, to be willing to trust Him that He has the resources to pull off what He said He's going to do. He said He'd be your protector, then you got to believe He's got the power to protect you. I don't believe that the American military can protect us against Russia and China, but I believe that the Father can. Yes. Where is your trust? To agree with Him, to believe in Him, to know that what He said is true. I've got a wellspring on the inside of me. I don't care what's going on. And I know the wellspring is always springing up into a river. I have a river. I'm the temple of the living God. He lives in me and dwells in me. And I'm not willing to let that fit within the framework of that which is merely human. I'm not going to let that be confined to the expressions of what other people are saying. This is what it looks like to be baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. I'm going to say no, that Jesus is what it looks like to be baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. The Apostle Paul is what it looks like to be baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. Look at what they did. Examine their lives. Look at what took place with them. Look at the fruit of their lives. Look at the manifestation of the power of God through them. Look at what they were able to accomplish. William Booth wasn't baptized in the Holy Ghost and fire. He was consecrated to live out the Word of God. He was consecrated to live out the Word of God. He didn't know anything about baptism in the Holy Ghost and fire. Maybe later on in his life that actually happened, but when he started it, what? Anything about it. It was more akin to the Anabaptist movement. Come on, people. What Father's looking for is the depths of a heart. The depths of a heart. I've got to have this, God. I've got to know you. And that's why the more you begin to talk about Him and declare who He is, and it's coming out of your mouth, out of your mouth. Have you ever noticed that if you'll sit down and you'll start telling somebody about your problem, it suddenly sounds so stupid? It's like, this real, you know, I thought this was a lot worse before I started saying it, and now I really don't need to say anything because I'm embarrassed at this moment and realize it's not quite as bad as what I thought. Huh? People, there's great discovery when you start listening to your mouth, to your ears hear what your mouth declares. There's great discovery. You start telling Father who He is. God, You the Almighty. You the Creator of the heavens and the earth. You laid the foundations of the earth. Before there was anything, Father, You existed there. You are the great I Am. You are the one who looked upon my life and loved me so that You gave me Your only begotten Son as a sacrifice, as my own lamb, so I could live with You and You the Most High. You the Almighty. You my God, and I'm Your people. You start, look, people, before long you're going to have a revelation of who He is. And what else is going to happen? Before long, you're going to start moving in the faith of who He is. Because you're going to start moving in the faith of who He made you instead of just sitting around feeling the anointing. There's people, they don't feel the presence of the Lord. Half people don't feel the presence of the Lord. Half the people feel the anointing. And you don't even know what's going on in the place. I want to see somebody move in signs and wonders and miracles. I want to see somebody quit sitting there on the altar waiting for the fire to fall, because that is a smelly thing. You put an offering on this altar and the fire is going to fall right away. Fire is going to fall. Fire is going to fall. Cizo rimon baste presteya. Father's going to stand in the midst of it. Oh, those burning lamps. Oh, that furnace of fire. It stood in the midst of Abraham's sacrifice. His Father vows Himself to a man. His Father consecrates Himself to a man. Father's consecrated Himself to us. He consecrated himself to us that we may be consecrated to him. What a marriage. Your foul spirit of sickness and disease, your foul spirit of virus and plague and bacteria, your foul spirit of hell, you demon spirit of darkness, I curse you in the name of Jesus Christ, and I command you to leave the property of God alone. We defy you. We defy you. We resist you. We'll have nothing to do with your garbage. We'll have nothing to do with your foul ways. We'll have nothing to do with those things of death and corruption and sickness and plague and offense and destruction that you would try to impose upon us. Hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah to the Lamb. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah to the Lamb. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you to the Lamb. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you. Lord, I love you forevermore. And I will worship. Oh God, I will worship you. From the rising of the sun, oh God, I will worship you. I will worship you. I will adore you. I will be a living sacrifice. Oh God, I will worship you. Oh, I will worship you. From the rising of the sun, oh God, I will worship you. I will worship you. Lord, I will adore you. I will be your living sacrifice. Just do that. Just do that. Everything will change. Just everything will change. You'll find yourself released into the greatness of God. You'll find yourself released into the power and the demonstration of His glory. You'll find yourself released into a personal relationship with Him that goes beyond anything that you've known. I will worship you. Lord, I will worship you. From the rising of the sun, I will worship you. I will worship you, Lord. I will adore you. I will be your living sacrifice. That's beautiful, Allie. I will worship you. I will worship you. From the rising of the sun. From the rising of the sun. Lord, I will worship you. I will worship you. refined soul, Lord. I will be your living sacrifice. If you'll wait on God, he'll begin to move through you. Waiting on God is on sitting in silence. Waiting on God has a whole lot of zeal and passion. It's a laying a hold on him. It's having that which he demands. It's being filled with that which he supplies. It's talking to the rock, Christ Jesus, and saying, Lord, I must have a drink. Lord, I must have your water. Lord, I must have the rising up of your joy in me. I must have the rising up of your praise in me. I do not look to myself. I do not look within my own self to somehow try to produce this miracle, and I won't have it that way. I'm looking for your divine unction, Holy Spirit. I'm looking for your divine moving in my life. I'm looking for that which only you can supply. I'm looking for the busting forth of your divine glory. Fill me now. Fill me now. Fill me now. Fill me now. I yield myself to you. Fill me now. Fill me now. Fill me now. I yield myself to you. Oh God, fill me now. Lord, fill me now. Fill me now. I yield myself to you. Be glorified. Be glorified. Be magnified. I yield to you. Oh God, fill me now. Fill me now. I yield myself to you. Oh God, now fill me now. Fill me now. I yield myself to you. Oh Lord, fill me now. Fill me now. Oh God, be glorified. Be magnified. Oh God, I yield myself to you. Everybody, stand with me. Thank you so much for coming here tonight, being with us, worshiping God with us, putting God first no matter what coming out against you. Hear the Father say to you that the things that he described in his word is as real today as they were the day that he first sent them. The blood of Jesus Christ has not at all lost its power. It's effective as right at this very moment as it was on the very day that it was shed. The baptism in the Holy Ghost and fire and the working of the Holy Spirit is more powerful than ever because of the increase of his government. There should be no end. His healing flow, his authority that he's placed on the inside of you and I, and the power that he's given to you and me to be his servants and to be his witnesses, the ministry of heaven. It's ours. The thief will try to cheat you. The thief will try to keep from you this extraordinary life, this life of God. Father leaves it to our will and to our decision as to whether or not we'll let him work the miracle for us. Whether or not we'll participate with the flowing forth of his glory through our lives, the wellspring, the river there. Whether or not we're going to wake up in the morning and say, I'm the temple of the living God. I'm going to move with you, Father. I'm going to walk with you. Hallelujah. This body will be so healthy in the morning when I wake up. Hallelujah. Oh, fill me now. Oh, God, fill me now. Oh, God, I yield myself to you. Fill me now. Oh, Lord, fill me now. Oh, God, I yield myself to you. Oh, fill me now. Oh, Lord, fill me now. I yield myself to you. Be glorified, be magnified. I yield myself to you. Oh, fill me now. Oh, God, fill me now. Oh, Lord, I yield myself to you. Oh, God, fill me now. Oh, Lord, fill me now. I yield myself to you.
Oh Lord, fill me now. I yield myself to you. Be glorified, be magnified. Yield myself
to you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hey folks, listen, I'm so blessed. Last week we were able to give Jake about a $6,000 offering. It was over $6,000. The week before that, about $2,300 came in for ministering to the untouchables in India. Well, what a blessing that was for them. The week before that, you know, it just, there was another ministry, and I just, what God is, you're allowing God to do in your life, and I promise you'll be having no lack.
Amen.
I promise you, the more you give, the more you're able to speak the word of faith and watch the miracle take place. I promise you. I promise you. Father's going to make sure he multiplies. He don't add. He multiplies. Praise God. Hallelujah. And right now we're getting ready to move into another phase with the church in Oregon. And we want you to be part of giving for the church in Oregon. The church in Oregon is going to be a Holy Ghost place like Oregon has never even seen. I mean, we are going in God for such Holy Ghost conviction and such splendor and such beauty and such majesty of His presence, because sometimes people equate Holy Ghost conviction to some howling and condemnation. No, it's not. It's a place of moving into deep depths in God and yieldingness to Him so that everything that is pure and divine is revealed in the place. And so we want to encourage you, if you have made a pledge, follow through on the pledge. If you haven't made a pledge, here's pledge cards. And really tonight, this offering tonight is really going to be about the church in Oregon. And now, honestly, you must understand, there are certain things that you've got to keep before the Lord as a living sacrifice. People want the fire to fall upon their life, but they're not willing to obey God and do what's right. Your offerings only begin after your tithe is finished. Let me say that again. Your offering begins after your tithe is finished. It's true. Somebody said, well, my cousins need new shoes, and so I'm sending Auntie my tithe money. Bless your heart, it don't work that way. That is just generosity. That you get has nothing to do with the house of the Lord. And, you know, God loves a cheerful giver. He hates one who's not. I mean, that's pretty radical to say, but I mean, come on, God's just extreme. He hates one who's grumpy about it. He just says, hold on, I don't want that. You with me? We'll say we want one side of it, but we're not willing to consider the other side. He loves a cheerful giver. You don't have to do it. Your heart's in the giving. You know, you don't have to praise. He doesn't want people just lip syncing praise to Him. They ain't got to do nothing. He wants the heart in it.
Amen.
And in that place, there's a realm of faith. And He says, in that place of faith, I will cause all grace to abound in you. And think about that. People, that is the unlimited expression of stepping in to all the Father has. You can fast and you can pray and you can do all these things, but if you don't do the fundamental things that Father's asked us to do that are indicators of our relationship, they don't establish the relationship, they don't make the relationship, they're just indicators that our relationship is right. That's all they are. They're just indicators that our heart's right. It's just witnesses, it's signposts to us, telling us whether we're going down the right road or not. Some people are going down in one way, a one-way street, and they just as happy and as oblivious to it. The one way, the wrong way. You can continue on being excited and praising. I mean, it doesn't take a hand clap. I mean, clapping is worship. It's a form of worship, but there's many other forms of worship too. It just, I can feel that. I just can feel, you know, the vapor lock take place. Don't do that. Because that's where your heart's at. Your money's where your heart's at. Your heart's where your money's at. Let it be all in the kingdom of God. Let it be in a realm of faith. Let it be in a realm of faith. Said, well, Pastor, we gave $6,000 last week. And usually the people that are asking that question didn't give much. Pastor, we gave $2,400 the week before. People that asked that question didn't give much. They gave 20 of it. Are you with me? Don't get into that thing. Don't allow that thing to happen. Because Father is a big God. Once again, He's a big God. And now He's going to settle down where it really counts and says, how do you feel about me now? Now that we're talking about your money, do you think I'm still big?
Oh, yeah, that's what he does. He does. Yeah, because we can be all excited so long as it's just a general talking. He's a big, big God. He's for me, and I can trust him. But then he gets right down into the nitty-gritty of, uh-oh. And he's looking at you going, while you're sitting there, while you're sitting there getting all jittery, he's looking at you going, how do you feel about the relationship now? Am I still a big God? Am I still a miracle worker? Am I still a provider? Dear people, Father has purposed that you and I take the gospel to the ends of the earth. And we want to be just begin to heave towards that direction. We want to take what we're doing now and let everything that we're doing now move us to that place in the future where we're doing more. And so, therefore, we don't hold on to anything or count our life dear unto ourselves. We just going after this thing and saying, okay, look, what are we doing next? You guys should be saying, wow, Pastor, you're moving a little slow. I mean, we're only planting one church this year. How many crusades are we doing? After all, look at what happened in Nepal. We could reproduce that over and over again. Instead of saying, you got to go to another teal to get some money. Come on now, talk to me. Look at me and say, yeah, that's right, Pastor. Come on, say somebody. You're right, Pastor. That's right. I know some people have been thinking that way, but it hadn't been me. Come on. Come on, interact. This is interactive. Relationship with Jesus is interactive. Just saying, oh, we only have so much money. Well, we're really not interested in what you only have. We're interested in the miracle that you're willing to cooperate with. We're interested in you proving God. We're interested in you laying hold of God in such a way that nobody's even seen what you did. No one's ever even reckoned that there was that kind of relationship to have with him. That's what William Booth did. That's what so many people in history did. Yeah. Paul did it. Everybody's like looking at Paul going, wow, look at what this guy is doing. The Lord says, yeah, I'm just going to let him write the Bible. And Peter's like, can I have a chapter? He said, okay, you can have a chapter. The passion, people, the passion, the passion, the passion, the zeal, the intensity, the intensity. Those are all expressions for fire, the passion. The zeal. It's all expressions of fire. Yeah. Will you let the Lord kiss you? Yeah. Right now, would you? Right now, when you're being challenged, will you let him hug you and tell you it's going to be all right? Yeah. Trust me. Yeah. You can walk on the water. Trust me. Yeah. You can step out beyond yourself. Trust me. Trust me. I'll give you more than your savings account could have ever produced. Ann and I have been trying to have a savings account for many years now. We've been trying. We got this new plan to have one. For a particular purpose. But what we found is that when we've been in need and when there's been things that we had to have, we just spoke it out to the Lord, said, Father, supply this. And it was always a miracle on the same level, unique though, as going to a fish's mouth and getting a coin. Yeah. Or having it brought to us from the king's table by a raven. Or having it broken and blessed by Jesus. Wow. I want you to experience it. I'm going to see nothing but his miracle power. I'm going to learn to see with the eyes of faith and only the eyes of faith. I'm going to shut my natural eyes. And I'm going to see only with the eyes of faith and begin to behold the greatness of his power. The unlimited blessings of his divine grace that has been imparted to me so that I can stand in the same place like those that came before me. Live big for God. And I'm saying this of you. I'm saying this of you. I want you to look at the passion and the zeal and the fervency dial of your life. And if it's not turned all the way up to maximum, and mine's turned up to maximum, and I'm trying to see if I can get a little bit more to turn a little bit more. Do it. At the end of this week, we'll be in Indiana, and we pray that all of you will go with us in prayers because we believe in God to do great, extraordinary miracles in Indiana. We're going to be in Princeton, Indiana.
Elizabeth's going with us on this trip. I know. Special artillery. Hallelujah. And we really, from our perspective of things, we want to be somewhere constantly every week. But the Lord is laboring. He's laboring to bring something forth in here. Let's labor with Him. He's moving to bring something forth in our lives. Let's move with Him. He's earnest to hasten the word which He's pronounced in our lives. Let's run with Him. Let's hasten. Father, we love the beauty and the splendor of Your nature. Father, we love the glory of Your holiness and of Your purity. We thank You, Father, that You're right there leading us and guiding us and teaching us and telling us and bringing Holy Ghost conviction when it's something that we're not supposed to have, and bringing joy and rejoicing when it is that which we're supposed to be doing. We thank You for Your peace that passes understanding. Tonight, Father, I ask You for the miracle of revelation to fall upon every person in this place, to realize one simple thing, that if they will obey Your word, they will have fullness of joy. Lord, to recognize that You wrote these things unto us that our joy may be full, that we may have fullness of joy.
Yes.
And all we have to do is agree with You.
Yes,
Lord. All we have to do is believe what You said.
Yes, Lord.
Thank
You, Jesus.
Amen.
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 Thank You, Jesus. Thank You, Jesus. I just want you to spend a little time thanking Him and praising Him.
Yes, Lord.
Spend a little time praising Him. Those of you that are watching right now by the web or on YouTube or by FaceStream, just spend a little time worshiping and praising Him and thanking Him for all the goodness. It don't matter how you feel. It doesn't matter what's been going on. Just turn your heart to Him. If you've had sin and wrongdoing going on in your life, just say, Lord Jesus, cleanse me right now. Wash me. And let God purify you. Purify your conscience. Purify your thoughts. Purify your thinking. He'll make you instantaneously holy and acceptable unto Himself. He'll fill you with the Holy Ghost right now. He'll fill you with His presence. He'll fill you with His Spirit. He'll fill you with His power. He will not withhold any good things from you. He'll freely give you all things. Hallelujah. Just begin to give thanks to Him. Just walk around right now and just begin to say, Lord, You're so good to me. And I thank You, Father, that that goodness never comes to an end. Hallelujah. Come worship the Lord with your offering. And anybody who wants prayer, we're here to pray with you. If there's anybody in the building tonight, you've not had the miracle of salvation, you've not had that one encounter that God has made available for every single man to have, the greatest encounter that you can have, the encounter where Christ Jesus becomes real to you. You call upon His name and He gives you a new heart, a new spirit, and puts His own Holy Spirit on the inside of you. Understand, He's calling you right now. Heaven is mobilized for your soul. Heaven is mobilized for your response. For it was for you Christ Jesus died. Do not delay. There is a great miracle that will happen right now today as you call upon the name of Jesus. Once again, if there's anybody in the house you want us to pray with you for anything, you've had some kind of sickness, some kind of disease, some kind of torment, some kind of affliction, some kind of virus coming at you, some kind of harassing, tormenting thing trying to impose upon you some other identity than what God has established and settled forever. And come, we'll pray with you and for you. Those of you that are watching by web right now, in Jesus' name, go free. I loose you now. I release you now.
from every stronghold of the enemy, from every lying, tormenting spirit. Right now, God fills you with the grace and divine ability to agree with His word, to believe what He said, and you'll have the miracle as a result. You just agree with Him. Maybe things will come, try to push you around, try to get you to back down, change your opinion, and change your mind. But don't. Just agree with God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear your voice. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Give praise to the Father through Jesus, His Son. And give God the glory. Great things He has done. Oh, praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear your voice. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let His people rejoice. Give praise to the Father through Jesus, His Son, and give Him the glory. Great things He has done. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the people, the world hear your voice. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Give praise to the Father through Jesus, His Son, and give Him the glory. Great things He has done. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the earth hear your voice. Your voice. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Let the people rejoice. Give praise to the Father through Jesus, His Son, and give Him the glory. Great things He has done. Just lift your hands towards heaven and receive right now. If you're not up here and you're standing back there, hallelujah. Go ahead and interact with God and begin to pray and intercede and for the people that are up here. Don't be aloof from what God is doing. God has purposed you to do it with Him. God has purposed for you to be part of every person being touched in this place tonight. He wants you to engage. He wants you to be right there with it. He wants you to be right there with it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The first thing I want to do is I want to pray for anybody that's standing up here. You have any kind of anxiety attack, any kind of pressure on your chest. You're having to deal with some kind of, you know, heart pain. It's not really heart pain. It's just tension that's going on in your life. I want to pray for you right now. So you're going to move to the center, and who's ever in the center is going to give you room. So just quickly do that. Just quickly do that. Quickly do that. Quickly. That's good. That's good. Just come on. And let God touch you and every one of you. Get ready, because Father knows your personal need. He's going to touch you. Hallelujah. This isn't just going to settle in on four people, five people. He's going to touch you. God loves you. Hallelujah. He does. Loves you, man. My God. You're getting released right now. That thing's being released off of you, and it can't come back. It can't come back. I said it can't come back. It can't come back. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. It can't come back. Can't come back. Thank you, Jesus. The fire of the Holy Spirit. Modestan and mainly Kaylee Kushti, the landman, it can't come back. And Lemon Jessica Nostra, and it can't come back. And it's ha ha and it can't come back. Thank you, Jesus, for your glory now. Just lift your hands towards heaven. I don't know that God has shown you specifically what's happening with you, but you name your request before the Lord as I come by. Those of you who are sitting out there in Saint Land, you want to go ahead and be participating with every person who's getting touched right now. You know that the power of God, the miracle power of God, is working right now. Looky up here. What's going on with you?
I got got a little bit of sore throat.
Well, be healed. Be healed. Be healed. I command it, go out of your body right now in Jesus' name. Now, you can do the same thing. You don't even need my... If you've been baptized in the Holy Ghost and power, you don't need me. You can command it to go out of your body in Jesus' name too. Hallelujah. But we'll be helpers of your faith. What is it that you need?
I tweaked my shoulder a little bit.
What does it mean to tweak?
Like hurt it.
You hurt your shoulder. Okay. Hallelujah. We usually tweak things to make them work better. So let us tweak it. In Jesus' name.
Thank you.
Amen. I drive the pain out in Jesus' name from your body.
Thank you, Father.
And just lift your hand towards heaven. Just worship the Lord for healing.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you,
Father, for healing. Thank
just
you, Lord,
worship
Jesus.
Him.
Your Father, you're so awesome.
What's wrong? Well, in the name of Jesus, those things quit swelling on you. Inflammation, go down right now in Jesus' name. Right now, I speak to this heart right now in Jesus' name. Why didn't you come stand over there with the heart people? Okay, that's fine too. If it's a done deal, it's a done deal now in Jesus' name. Huh? Elevate those feet. Elevate those feet. Look at them and say, oh, how... No. You say, oh, how beautiful are the feet. Say, oh, how beautiful are the feet. How's your arm doing? Huh?
It's feeling good. It's feeling better.
What is it that you need? In Jesus' name. Be healed.
Lord, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Be healed right now. What do you need?
It was my
throat. It was. I once had a sore throat, but now I don't. Amen. Hallelujah. I once was lost, but now I'm found. What do you need, daughter of the Lord? What do you need?
The Father loves you so much, He'll supply all your needs according to His riches and glory right now. He did it for you. He did it for you right now.
Jesus. God says have no agreement with anything that's not of His Spirit. God says separate yourself and have no agreement with anything that does not belong to heaven and the realms of the Holy Spirit and the realms of that which He Himself is doing. God says separate yourself and agree with nothing unless it's written in His Word. Agree with nothing. If you can't find a verse for it, don't agree with it. This is what the Lord says. Huh? Why? Because He's fashioned you and purposed you for this time. Oh, some people think that this is going to happen and that's going to happen. But Father's got great things that He's planned that only His servants have revealed to them. And He's getting ready those who are willing to move with Him and want to move with Him and want to be used by Him. So you just be that person now. Oh, daughter of the Lord, stand up. Oh, daughter of the Lord, stand up. Oh, daughter of the Lord, stand up and take your place among the mighty of the Lord. Oh, daughter of the Lord, it is time. Oh, daughter of the Lord, it is time. It is time to celebrate, drink the wine and eat the sweet. Oh, daughter of the Lord, it is time. Wind, 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 wind blow. Rushing mighty wind blow, streams of heaven flow, power of God be revealed in your dark, great signs, wonders, and You know, there's many people who've had to go through great suffering and defeat. Mariah Woodworth Edder, for example, was one of those people because she was being opposed by everything from man to devils, lost 8 children, they died on her. Had to suffer many things because she did not know how to stand against them. She did not know how to move in what God said in His word of authority. But she did not change and she did not back down, and she continued to pursue, and then great signs and wonders and miracles begin to be wrought by her. Many times, God will allow Satan to do certain things that look so devastating and disastrous. But what happens is He calls to spring forth something far greater than the enemy tried to steal. I said He calls to spring forth something far greater than the enemy tried to steal. Only believe. Only believe. All things are possible. Only believe. Oh, only believe. Only believe. Oh, all things are possible. Only believe. Sing it. Say, Lord, I believe. Oh, Lord, I believe. It's beautiful, honey. Oh, Lord, I believe. All things are possible. Lord, I believe. Oh, Lord, I believe. Lord, I believe. All things are possible, and they're possible for me. Mandambre de Sisiki. Thank you, Jesus.
Healed.
Healed. Healed. The prince in the power of the air is distributing his flu. The prince in the power of the air is distributing his sickness. The prince in the power of the air is distributing his affliction. The prince in the power of the air distributing his shame and his lying condemnation. But you're not receiving.
No.
You're not in line for the distribution. That's right. You begin to lift up your voice. You begin to lift up your voice. Look, you begin to lift up your voice till something happens. I don't care how messy it is, how ugly it is, how weird it is. You begin to lift up your voice until, until something happens. You begin to lift up your voice until something. What's going on up here, folks? Huh? It's not my brother, not my sister, but it's me, oh Lord, standing in the need of prayer. What would you like the Lord to do? You have an owie? Would the Lord... is a professional owie healer. So right now, in the name of Jesus, owie, be gone. And what is it that you need? Miles, Junior, what is it that you need, buddy? Huh? Can you put it into words? Well, touch him right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. Touch him right now, Lord, in Jesus' name. Dear sister, what is it that you need?
More faith.
Father, we thank you that you increase faith in our lives. You do it. It's a miracle that only you can do. You provide it. Listen, if you're going to do it, get on another program. Don't do any half measures, because that's awkward. No half measures. If you're going to do it, get on with it. Otherwise, just wait. Listen, the cry of the heart is a beautiful sound. I'm never disturbed by it. I'm never. I promise you. Because I'm in a realm of cooperating with the Holy Ghost, and think about it. You get in this place, and anything that's not Him just sticks out. Just sticks out. And I pray in the name of Jesus that you begin to walk in the miracle relationship with the Lord, that anything that's not of God just sticks out. Yes. And it just is awkward, and it's ugly, and it don't belong. Huh? Amen? Yes. The Lord answers your prayers right now. He answers all your prayers. Lord, answer all your daughter's prayers right now. What is it that you need? Your what? Provision. Lift your hand towards heaven. Now in Jesus' name. Now in Jesus' name. Your visa will be renewed. In Jesus' name. And you will go ahead and you will become a citizen. In Jesus' name. And no man will have their way. Your children are citizens. You'll be a citizen too. And God will trump Trump. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Men have a long history of making messiahs out of humanistic political figures. Long history. And I'm not planning on participating. I praise God for any good thing that's happening. Many times the good things got accompanied with a bunch of bad things too. It's just true. I'm standing with Jesus. I'm standing with Him. If He believes in it, I believe in it. And that's it. That's what I'm going with Him. I'm going with Him. And the Lord said more in the Old Testament to take care of the stranger and the alien than He did keep the Sabbath. True. And I'm telling you right now, we're not going to get blessed kicking everybody out of the country and still continuing on with abortions. Deal with the abortions first. I say invite all the ISIS into town. Have a move of God, let them all get saved. Amen. So you say, I'm glad you're not president. Well, I just want you to know, I'm going to lay down my life for my enemies. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to feed those who are hungry. I'm going to do it Jesus' way. I'll do it government way. It's too bad. So many churches are acting like the government. Come on. Government's been. We're supposed to represent the government of the kingdom. It's full of love and grace and mercy and goodness and kindness. Hallelujah. My, if we start trusting God, all of our enemies would be at peace with us and we wouldn't even need a military. Well, that's another subject. What is it that you need? I just figured this out. I mean, I had to pray for a visa. Her children. This is what goes on. This is the practical reality here, people. Children are citizens and her... What is it that you need? No. They gotta surrender to God. They fight in God. You can't run from God and get a miracle. So we're gonna believe for I will believe for a miracle with you that the Lord will send some labor into the harvest. You see what I'm saying? When the Lord told us, when He said when we're dealing with the lost, He told us how to pray, gave us wisdom and insight, and if we'll do it with Him His way, we'll get His results. He said, for us to pray that the Lord of the harvest would send forth laborers into the harvest field. And so I pray right now that the Lord will send forth a laborer to this young girl that you're talking about, Josie, and that she will surrender up her life to the healing power of Jesus Christ. And once you lift your hands towards heaven and start looking and start moving in some wonderful supernatural realms of faith, simply because you agree with God's word, you start doing it His way. Good. Just a rushing mighty wind over here, Lord Jesus. God wants you to be bold, confident, certain. radical authority. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. What is that that you need?
Lower back pain.
How long have you had it?
Over a month.
Okay.
Over a month and a half.
Do you have an accident or something?
I'm not sure. Just hurt it and then been straining it playing sports.
Okay. Well, I see that you've given your life to Jesus. Have you been baptized in the Holy Ghost since you believed?
Yes.
Good. That wonderful expression of His rivers and His life, His divine glory flowing out of you will stop every pain, every sickness, every disease. You begin to let that flow come stronger and stronger. And the more you do it, the more you participate with God, the stronger it comes. Somebody said, how can I have stronger faith? Give yourself to the realms of faith. How can prayer be stronger in my life? Do more prayer. How can the river and the presence of God, manifest presence of God, be more overwhelming in my life? Give yourself more to it. Now in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I come in this pain. What's your name?
Julian.
Hmm?
Julian.
Julian. I command this pain to go out of Julian's body now. Get out of your back. Now. Now just move it around. Just check it. Begin to do something you couldn't do before. The pain go out.
A little bit less.
Good. Just begin to worship in the house. Julian, just begin to worship in the house. Just get your hands straight now to heaven and just begin to worship Him for His miracle power in your life. Because I promise you, if it hurts a little less, it's just on its way out. Overwhelmed with the presence of the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And you know what? There's going to be perfect submission in your life. Yeah. Yes, there is. There's going to be no rebellion, no defiance. There's just going to be that wonderful submission and obedience and lowliness and meekness. Yeah. Uh-huh. You're just going to learn how to be conformed to the image of Jesus, no matter how challenging, no matter how much it hurts, because God's got a ring of authority He's going to place upon you. If you'll just do it His way. I know it gets hard. I know it gets challenging. But you're going to do it His way. You're going to do it His way. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed is the name of the Lord Jesus. And He gives you strength to do it. He gives you a strength to do it. You say, strengthen me, Lord, when you need it. And He'll strengthen you every time. Yes, He will. You're not on your own. No, you're not. You're not on your own. Hallelujah. Isn't that good? That you're not on your own. Huh? Isn't that wonderful that He loves you? Isn't that wonderful that He loves you? Huh? Isn't that wonderful that He loves you? Isn't that wonderful that He loves you? Now, you can have that all the time. You can do that. Just walk around the house. I pray that you'll be drunk for many days. If you get drunk for many days, it's very easy then for you to get drunk anytime. Because you've been living in that realm, it's like you can just go right back over there anytime. Just caught away in the glory. Hallelujah. Praise the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Lift up your head. Lift up those hands which hang down. Let that which is lame be healed, lest it turn you out of the way. Oh, woman of faith. Woman of faith. Hey, miracle faith. Get strong, get bold, get courageous. Start speaking the things. In Jesus' name, start moving the mountains around. Leave Palomar where it is, because I like it. See the Romance, it's so beautiful. Hallelujah. Borushita la Makia. But otherwise, just go after it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mount Palomar is in my backyard now. I like looking at it. Wouldn't want anybody moving that. Hallelujah. Sickness and disease, and torment and pain. Ha. Huh? Uncertainty, whatever would plague you, has to release you. Released. Loose them and let them go. Huh? I loose you right now and I let you go. I release you right now from all the past. I release you. I release you from the sins of the past. I'm going to be held on you no more. How you like that? Isn't that good news? Released. Thank you, Jesus, for the anointing. Thank you, Jesus. Fire on the Holy Ghost. Fire on the Holy Ghost. Thank you, Jesus.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. Let God have His way. God have His way. Fire God on you. Fire the Holy Ghost. Let God have His way. Let God have His way. Let God have His way. Here's what the Lord says. Are you ready for this? Are you ready for this? You ready? Quit trying so hard. Hallelujah. Praise God. Woo! Mambo Shea Mona Ria Nakasi Flost. Mean they rushly makes to preface. Thank you, Jesus. For my little sister. For your fiery Holy Ghost servant. Full of faith. Full of the Spirit. Full of the Word, full of power, might, and strength. Bumbling, being prepared by you, O God, to take on anything that hell can try to throw at her. Hallelujah. And be able to stand in your glory and stand in your authority and the power and the strength of your might and put every alien, and that's used in the right way, every demon spirit to flight. Hallelujah. Everything's not supposed to be around. Cast out by Brittany. Brittany of God. Brittany of the Spirit. Brittany who rules and reigns with Christ Jesus in this life right now. Brittany who is seated together with Him. Hallelujah. In a heavenly realm. With His authority and with His power to speak out His word. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I like it. Well, I pray in Jesus' name every one of you go home tonight just so blessed. And I pray in Jesus' name that to you the church will be the most exciting, most wonderful, and most glorious place to come to. And that you'll be so excited about it. Because if that begins to happen in you, I'm going to tell you what's going to happen. People are going to begin to see it, and it's going to happen in them. And I'm talking about not somebody from another church. I'm talking about a lost and dying world who's never had an opportunity to see. You have a responsibility. And it begins with the way that you're going to live your life tomorrow. With the choices that you're going to make tomorrow. Doesn't it begin with you going over to Kashmir? It begins with the way that you're going to decide how you're going to live and behave yourself tomorrow. Yield yourself to the Holy Spirit because nobody has the ability or the wherewithal to be what God has purposed and created us to be. But He's provided for us supernatural strength by the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let the river flow. Yes. Give yourself, yield yourself to God and watch what God will do. And I pray that you walk around in the glory of heaven, that you walk around in His presence. Hallelujah. Start. All you got to do is just begin to say anything about Jesus and you're overwhelmed with His presence. All I got to do is say anything about joy and you can't hardly shut it off. Huh? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, amen. 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 Find a bunch of people. Hug them. Tell them that you love them. Bless them in the name of the Lord Jesus. We'll be back here Wednesday night. Be in prayer. Be in intercession. Be in consecration for what God's going to do through you then. In the coming together of His saints. Hallelujah.